So we're still here with Tim at Prismic Studio. In the first video, we talked about why Next is a viable solution if you're like for doing websites and evolving your website as well.
Right.
And then we talked about like this video. We'll talk more about the AMP rendering and how is it interesting. Well, first, maybe can you give us an introduction on what AMP is?
Right. So AMP is a standard that was started by Google, and it's basically a standard to build fast web pages. And the way it does that is it's an extension on HTML, basically, with web components. So you don't use like a client-side rendered application, but you server render everything that is then used. For example, you use AMP components to enhance the experience instead of doing your JavaScript. Own client-side JavaScript code. Right.
So there are more components so that you can have still richer experience, but everything is rendered already.
Yeah, and all the components are optimized to be as fast as possible, basically.
Right. So do I need special browser support to be able to use AMP?
No, because the way it works is it's just a JavaScript library. But the more interesting part of AMP is that crawlers, so for example, Google and Bing, they index AMP pages, and they on mobile use it for their search experience. So for example, if you search for a news website, and you generally like on mobile see like this lightning icon, which is actually that it supports AMP. And if you click on that link, it will actually render the page, it's like the web page inside of Google instead of going to your website.
Instead of going to the browser and going to the actual website and all that.
Yes, it's and the experience it's extremely much quicker. Fast. Yeah. Because the rendering happens basically inside of Google, and everything is cached inside of Google.
Okay.
Yeah.
And also the click, since you are still inside the Google search experience, you know, you're not committing to go a different website. You're still reading while being at Google.
Yes.
So that's also more engagement. Maybe it brings
more
engagement.
Yeah, so we used it for Next.js.org, for example, and we saw that our engagement went up on the search engine traffic, basically.
Nice. Yeah. Nice. And so do you support AMP in some way with Next?
Right. So Next has support for rendering AMP. So that means that you still use React components to build your whole website. But then you have basically two ways to render, which is if you opt into AMP, you can say per page if it's going to use AMP or not. And there's two ways to do AMP. The first is AMP hybrid, which means that you opt into AMP, but then only for search engine traffic, for example. So the way that works is your whole experience is still just the React app that you already had, but then you can progressively add in the AMP pages, for example. The other is that you built your whole website in AMP, and then the pages for the for actual users are also in AMP.
So it renders in the browser as an AMP app.
Yes.
Right.
And we also optimize like that to be also faster.
So, but how about like if you go that path to do full AMP?
Right.
Does it mean that your website user experience will like be less rich than if you do JavaScript and React?
It really depends on what you want to do. For example, for most websites or most marketing pages, it makes total sense to use AMP to render the page itself, because generally it doesn't have like that many rich elements. So for example, you might have videos, which AMP has components for. So for example, you have like AMP YouTube as a component and that kind of thing.
Can I do sliders?
Yeah, there's a slider. There's like, I think like over 100 components.
Oh,
I'm not sure like what the exact number is, but like you can do anything from like embedding YouTube to embedding like Hulu videos to doing analytics. It basically has all these like pre-built components. They're all open source, by the way. So AMP itself is completely open source.
Mm-hmm.
And on top of that, you basically can decide like, oh, only this page is going to be full AMP. We do this for Next.js.org where the docs is, for example, completely AMP, but the homepage is not. It's hybrid.
Right. And is it only that's interesting for when browsing through mobiles, or is it also interesting if you're working on desktop?
So it only the rendering inside of Google, for example, only works on mobile.
Mm-hmm.
But maybe in the future it will actually also be used on desktop. However, the interesting part is that we've seen, for example, for Next.js.org, that the experience was actually much faster than when using React for like a completely static page, which is in general, like maybe you wouldn't even want to do like a JavaScript bundle that renders like your React app on the client side.
But that speed, it comes from the fact that AMP is very optimized, or it comes from the fact that AMP doesn't contain as much as React, and that's why it's faster. What is it?
It basically comes down to that AMP is very restricted in the way that you have to do things. So you have to use AMP components. You don't have your own custom JavaScript, which can be like growing, of course. And besides that, it also has the components that you use are optimized for rendering on the web, basically. And also, for example, it disallows using images, like normal IMG text, basically.
Mm-hmm.
And you have to use like AMP-image because that has lazy loading by default.
Oh, nice.
So it does lazy loading. And then also you have to provide the width and the height, which avoids the, maybe you have ever seen, like if you go to a website, it jumps like when the images load, right? It's a very common problem because people forget to add in the width and the height, basically.
It seems to me like the best practices of doing web pages faster and integrated into the library.
Yes.
Anyway.
Yeah. So it has a lot of restrictions that are there for a good reason, basically.
Cool. Well, maybe in there's one thing that last. So in Next, if I want to use AMP, then I will say like I will have to.
On your page, you have to export something. So on your page, you say like, oh, this page is going to be AMP. So it's not enabled by default. You have to like opt into it because it requires a few like very small changes on your components.
Right. Okay. Well, thank you. Maybe in the next video, we can go into more on some mechanics and specificities of using Next with other technologies.
Sure.
Thank you very much, Tim.
Thank you.